Check.
Okay, we're gonna mute that so that doesn't happen. So those girls just entered, they're already down here. About a 7 or 8 second lag, which is good. Excellent connection, you wanna keep eyes on that. You wanna keep eyes on this. You wanna keep eyes on this. This is the most important thing, because if this turns yellow, or worse, red, it means big duty.
Yeah.
Right now we are running off of tech, which doesn't seem to have really great connection here, which is weird, but it says we have an excellent connection, which means we should be getting plenty of feed. As of right now, we are live in here. They can hear us talking. I am going to keep this shut so that we can make a little more noise in here. I'm going to look around right here and see if we'll play in with the... to talk as little as possible. If I need to tell you guys something, I'll probably pull you into that room and have a conversation. Because like right now, I can hear this conversation, which is fine. I think sometimes people like to tune into the before stuff and hear everybody get started.
Thank you.
to see us. At this time, we would like to welcome our seniors back into the building for the very last time. We will be doing a quick walkthrough before the assembly. You will take your class out to the hallway real quick as we celebrate them and their accomplishments. Thank you. Then you will go back to your classroom and I will dismiss from there. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. just something you speak out there. Otherwise, with people like this, we can maybe... doing teachers giving awards. We can speed in like that. Thank you.
staff of Gravette High School, I would like to welcome our guests to our awards assembly for the 2023 school year. This morning we have a special guest with the Woodman Life American History Award. This award goes to a student that exhibits an affinity for the study of the history of our nation. It is being presented by the local chapter of the Woodman Life Fraternal Insurance, President Bob Morant. Completed 12 to 18 college credits and maintained a 3.0 GPA are recognized as rising scholars. Presenting these today will be Ms. Hawkins, our senior counselor. Our rising scholars are Mia Bassler, Derek Day, presenting these will be Coach Bohannon, Coach McKenzie, Coach Mormon, Coach Pittman, and Mr. Ray. We would like to congratulate Destiny Christian. Her award will be presented by Coach Mormon. Rachel Dill, presented by Coach Pittman. And Wesley Wilson, presented by President. for our academic awards, specific to classes and content. But before we do that, I want to give a huge thank you to Denise Griffith. She coordinates this program together, tells me what to say, tells me how to say it, and makes sure every teacher has everything they need to represent these students for their academic achievements. So I'd like to give a round of applause to you. Physical Education Awards. And when I announce this, the first name that I read will be our highest GPA or first place student, followed by the second place. If you would, please hold your applause until I've read both names. This year for health, we have Jaron Jackson and Lucas Kessler. Those were actually a tie, so they'll both be receiving the pin and the certificate. This year's Physical Education Award goes to Eric McMullen and Sebastian. To Teal Park. Thank you. perseverance, intercultural competence, and readiness for a 21st century global community is being awarded the Arkansas School of Biliteracy in English and Spanish to Lydia Wallace. RESL recipients, Unipsy Gonzalez and Daniela Martinez.
Thank you.
the literature, Ashlyn Fox and Skylar Hernandez.
Thank you.
and Mr. Batisha. Linder and Isabella Pratt.
Thank you.
Chemistry, Bryn Romine and Alexis Green.
Also for economics, Lydia Morales.
Hansel Bernal.
Thank you.
Art 2, Isabella Callahan, and Abigail Meester.
Thank you.
In Ag Mechanics, Matthew Wright and Emerson Stevens.
Thank you.
internship, Andrea Edwards and Jocelyn Kindred.
Thank you.
Growth and Development, Mackenzie Kleiser, and Bryn Romine. Foundations in Healthcare, Leah Thomason and Jaren Jackson.
Thank you.
Gravette, our fundamentals of AV Tech and Film, Mr. Galloway.
Yes, sir! Attaboy Gabe.
Thank you.
Arts recipients, Emily Heifel, who will be receiving honor awards. Delilah Shirley. Franklin Shirley. Smoots will present the certificates for vocational completers and office administration. McCoy Kildow, receiving high honors. And Lydia Morales, also receiving high honors. class representatives. For our senior class president and vice president, those will be recognized by Ms. Hicks and Mrs. Cole. And your senior class president and vice president, Miracle Franks and Will Betts.
Baseball season, the regional tournament, winning that, and the district tournament. Mine was beating Gentry and beating Perry Grove to send us to the district championship.
My favorite memory would be beating Gentry. My favorite memory from high school would have to be sports and athletics, all from golf all the way to track season, baseball, basketball, football, cross country, it's all in the last season.
Oh, probably the wrestling, Gravette, wrestling, you're on school.
I think my favorite memory was when I was in this club's physics class and we did an egg drop way over there.
Probably have a winning season of football and winning regional of baseball.
Just hanging out all the games, the student section, everything like that is just a really big deal for me, and I think that's just been my center of my entire life.
Making every job a two-person job for Mr. Deese.
My favorite memory of high school is probably my senior prom.
My favorite memory is definitely prom because it was just super fun to get to dance with my friends and bring my date and everything, and I just had a really good time.
My favorite high school memory would probably be being a part of GHS. I think this is like the first time I've ever been so close to like a group of people. And my favorite memory from that would probably be ASPA, because I think it was super cool and funny and fun.
My favorite memory from high school was all the teachers making fun of me.
Probably all the wrestling tournaments we went on at meeting Tyler this year, a pretty big deal. The bus ride back from all of our tournaments and the state trip, that was pretty fun.
My favorite memory was probably prom.
It's really nice just to get together and have some of these moments, especially when we win stuff, just to be together and just have like a little school
dream. My favorite memory from high school is the first day back from COVID. Just everyone excited to be back here and reconnect with everyone.
I'd say be confident in yourself. Put yourself out there for things. Don't be shy. The first time I figured out that I do things, it's like when I wrap myself out with really increasing people. So go on out there, do some things. Test your limits.
Some advice that I have for people is to definitely just come to school and get your work done. I definitely didn't really do that my senior year.
My stock in Joby and Delta was to go to English class. To work hard, but not to overexert yourself. And to take breaks to take care of yourself. But all in all, just like try to find a balance between work and break.
You only live once, so do what you want and don't care what other people think. Drama's not gonna matter after high school, so just ignore it, do what you want, don't care what others think, just be yourself and have fun.
Definitely don't procrastinate until the last second. It's just gonna mess up your grades, it's not good.
Don't procrastinate, honestly, no. And try and join stuff. It's fun. Just make it fun.
The advice that I would give to lower classmen would probably just to be going to all the football games and softball games and just to have fun while you're still in high school.
Pick a career now. It's never too late to start. I know I say it's never too late to start either. Because you kind of want to pick one now and adjust now. Don't just go and join a class with your friends.
Don't take your time for granted. It'll be over before you know it, and soon you'll regret everything that you didn't get a chance to do. Go out, make friends, make some memories, and have fun.
Advice that I would give is not to stress, because I know that's a big part of high school, just stressing about everything, and just living in the moment and making as many memories as you can.
My advice for the underclassmen is to not get too stressed out and to keep up with things, check your grades pretty often if you need.
My advice to you guys is to show up and try. Always try. Don't just like give up without trying.
Not to freak out. Like, it's not as bad as it seems. And just have fun.
Show up to school.
Have fun. Get involved. Live in the moment. Don't be held back by what everyone else thinks. Just be you.
Don't wait last minute.
And try to become more involved in clubs and organizations because it's so much fun.
Although I was only here for a year, I made so many friends and relationships and so many great memories.
That was a joke with the English class. Try to be a student aide for the office.
They'll be seated.
My advice for everyone is to not be afraid to branch out and try new things. And also to the boys that cut in lunch line every day, stop doing that. That's rude.
My advice is to make it to the time to meet class and don't scream in the hallways at 2 in the morning. It is a nightmare. Yeah, that's my advice.
Don't get a girlfriend. Do not get a girlfriend. At all.
Don't stop in the hallway and please stop making out in the hallway.
Can't say goodbye to like a specific group of people because I love most of the people in the school.
I would like to say goodbye to my fellow classmates, freshmen, sophomores, juniors. It's been a blast having a great school year with y'all, and wish the best to y'all.
Oh man, there are so many people to say goodbye to. Definitely everybody in the office, Ms. Hilger, Coach Rhodes.
I'm going to miss Mr. Gravette, Mackenzie, who's a chill guy.
I'm going to say goodbye to all of the students and faculty that I've just like gotten to know over the last 4 years, and all of the students that I've been in the school with since kindergarten, that they're all the people I've ever known, so I'm going to just say goodbye to those people and just everyone I've been a part of.
The biggest person I'll probably miss will probably be Coach Bearden, but I mean, I'm honest, like my basketball team, my golf team, they were like a really big part of high school for me.
Probably all my underclassmen friends.
Bye, Logan!
I would like to say goodbye to everyone, all of the students, faculty, staff, and teachers, coaches. I would like to thank all of you for everything that you've ever given me. Set me up for success for the rest of my life.
I would like to say goodbye to all of my underclassmen friends. And probably Mr. Galloway, because he's like the most patient person I've ever met. He's like super nice. He's like the first teacher ever. I want to say goodbye to all the friends that I've made in the lower grades and all the amazing teachers. Like, who's great, who's younger, who's cool. Just all of the kids that I've had.
Goodbye to all my teachers and all the people I met along the way. I want to say goodbye to Ms. Hartle because she was there for me and pushed me to get my work done and stuff. And she's a really great teacher and all.
I'd like to say goodbye to my little sister, who's a grade below me, my entire basketball team that I'm leaving behind, and all of my little FFA kids.
I want to say goodbye to Mr. Gravette, Mr. Griffith, and Coach Rhodes. They're the homies. I love them dearly. And I'll take a lot of life lessons from them, and I'll never forget them.
I want to say goodbye to like all my teachers and
Gravette,
Coach Rhodes, and a lot of good teachers here. And all
of
the students.
I definitely want to say goodbye to Miss Buck. She had a very big impact on my life and she helped me make it through my senior year.
I would like to say goodbye to Miss Bruce. I met her my sophomore year. I had no line, which I didn't really met her until last year. Ever since, I think she's like my school mom. I can talk to her with anything and she'll be there for me. So that's like an special thank you for her, and I appreciate her so much and I will miss her so much too.
Miss Denise.
Miss Denise.
And then I want to say goodbye to Mr. Garvin for believing in me and building my confidence and pushing me to do what he thought was best for me.
I want to say goodbye to Miss Newts and Miss Cole, Miss Mitchell, all the teachers that really led me through high school, all of my underclassmen friends, and definitely high school.
Goodbye.
Adios. Goodbye.
Sayonara.
Bye.
Goodbye. Okay, bye.
Ciao. Bye.
Bye.
All right, see you guys.
Goodbye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Goodbye, guys.
Goodbye,
guys.
Goodbye, GHS. Thank you.
There's no way I'll get picked. The next thing you knew, you were standing on the steps of the Capitol. So thank you for being open-minded and for taking the challenges that we pushed you for. The bus that I was on when we did the school tour this morning, your driver, he gave you some really good advice. And I hope that those of you that were on that bus heard that. And simply put, don't ever let anyone tell you you can't. You're from Gravette, Arkansas. The sign says the pride of Arkansas. Not only personal pride, but pride is in family. And know that when you leave here, the staff that was you're leaving behind, we're still here for you. And y'all have proven yourselves. You can compete with the biggest and greatest in the state of Arkansas and in this nation. So don't let anybody ever tell you you can't, no matter what it is. Okay? I love you guys. Senior class of 2023 of Gravette High School, we bid you farewell. Can make your way to the top of the pack.
class of, or new junior class, the class of 2025. Take your place.
Hammer last round.
Will!